We've already explained how monetary policy can influence your current account, that is your net exports. So let's formalize in more technical terms, because now you're better at this, using the terms domestic for yourself and foreign for your trading partners. So remember, what we're concerned here is relative interest rates, not absolute interest rates. It is how high or low your interest rates are relative to someone else, not the absolute level of interest rates that you have in isolation. So let's say that domestic interest rates are lower than those of your foreign interest rates. What happens? Domestic people will try to transfer their savings to foreign banks. In so doing, they'll sell your domestic currency on the forex market. This causes the supply of domestic currency on the forex market. And remember, this market is different from the domestic money market. This causes the supply of domestic currency to increase, causing your currency to depreciate against foreign currencies. The price of exports in foreign currency becomes cheaper. The price of imports in domestic currency becomes more expensive. If both are both have a price elastic demand, then the quantity of exports become increased more than proportionately, and the quantity of imports decrease more than proportionately. This causes the value of exports to increase and the value of imports to decrease, and eventually causing your net exports to increase. This improves your current account. Now, since the current account is a constituent portion of the overall balance of payments, then balance of payments tends to improve, but it still depends on the other accounts. A similar reasoning can be employed for the case where domestic interest rate is higher than foreign interest rate. If this happens, there'll be an inflow of hot money, as foreign investors would try to save their money in your country. They sell foreign currency on the forex market and buy your currency. When this happens, the demand for domestic currency increases and domestic currency appreciates against the foreign currency. The price of exports in foreign currency increases, price of imports in domestic currency decreases, quantity of exports decrease more than proportionately, quantity of imports increase more than proportionately. This causes the value of exports to decrease and the value of imports to increase. This worsens your net exports and causes the trade balance to worsen. This contributes to a worsening balance of payment. Now, an expansionary monetary policy may make your interest rate lower than those of other countries, but this is not absolutely true because it still depends on the interest rates of your trading partners. Similarly, when you apply contractionary monetary policy, it may cause your interest rates to be higher than those of your trading partners, but again, this depends on your relative interest rate and not the absolute one.